This is Damon Stevens with Thin Wealth Builders. Today is Wednesday, February 16, 2022, and this is Stock Market Update for Trades of the Day. And what a day it was. Boy, we ended up flat. I thought for sure we'd pick a direction or not with the Feds and with everything going on with Russia, but we ended up with a flat day. So that means obviously there's a lot to digest. And so let's get into the charts and see what they might help us as far as planning for the next day or two here, as we also get to options closing week on Friday. So, and also there's the market's not open in the US on Monday. So let's get into it, see what we need to plan for in this next couple of days to help us get through this. So you can see here, Dow Jones closed down 1.6%. The NASDAQ down 0.11%, and S&P 500 down or up 0.09%. So pretty much flat for the day. And so you can see, you know, we did kind of move down a little bit throughout the day. We were very flat waiting for the news. And then we pop back up and just kind of end up flat, which means, you know, a lot of indecision right there in the marketplace. You see the heat map here too is very jumbled as far as colors. You got all kinds of mixes here. You know, Google did end up and Amazon ended up a little bit, but Microsoft was down, Apple was down a little bit, Nvidia was down. We actually had some earnings come out too. So, I was amazed at how flat Nvidia was on its earnings. Obviously, it means that either we got some digesting to do or that we've already priced in a lot of the changes in the market. So let's take a look at some other charts here and see, you know, what we see coming forward. Looking at the earnings reports here, you can see obviously we came in a Thursday, and Walmart, Fiverr will be tomorrow, and so we'll be looking at a couple of those, and then again John Deere on Friday. For today, I didn't really see a whole lot on today that I wanted to look at. I mean, I did watch Nvidia, and so we'll take a look at that one. And we'll look at some other charts as far as some others that we actually have been watching that had earnings this week. So UPST, this is one that hopefully you got this one. We talked about this in our video last night. Actually moved up and actually closed higher today at 148.01. So that was a nice run on UPST. Looking for another run up here towards the 200 here at 148.79. So looking for some continuation on this one. So definitely watching UPST on our list. RHE is the one that we added. Regional Health Properties, you can see here, it continues to get higher highs. It's over all the moving averages, and it's got a long way to go. 735 is, you know, what we'd look for a possible next high here, but we got to get still above the 200. So looking at RHE and see a possible move there to help us, move up a little bit from where we're at right now. Looking at Exxon, Exxon's just there flat. It kind of bounced off the 20, which is good. That's what we want to see. So we continue to watch Exxon. Energy continues to lead out there in the market. Snapchat pulled back a little bit here, but it's just kind of consolidating right here in this little area. So for about a week now. So see if we can get strength to move up higher. Amazon closed a little higher today from yesterday. It's bounced off that 20. So looking for continuation play on Amazon. Okay, Google closed flat today, the day. Still under the 20 moving average here. Haven't got bumped up across there, but did find support here today. So looking to see a consolidation here and see if this can bump up tomorrow. Seeing how flat some of these stocks are, I really wonder if just we have not digested the information that's out there. So could be that we see a lot greater move over the next 2 days, especially tomorrow on Thursday. Maybe Thursday has more moves than the rest of the week. So let's just be careful on that, and we'll see what it brings. Looking at Apple here, you see, again, really flat today. So obviously a lot of indecision out there. So this is Boeing again, positive but flat for the day. Tesla flat. So I mean, not a lot to talk about tonight with all these stocks that are flat. So, but you see this huge consolidation on Tesla. So obviously it's building up a lot of energy. Hasn't moved a lot for about 2 weeks. So when it bumps, it's gonna move fast and furious here. to the upside or downside right now. A lot of the pressure's to the upside. So we'll hopefully we'll bust out and get a move forward here. NVIDIA, same thing. So you can see the stocks are really, the bulls are really trying to get out and really try to push the market higher, but those bears are keeping them down so far. But that means a lot of energy is building up here to move one direction or the other. I look at Facebook. Facebook pulled back a little bit. This was a little bit of a play today. Grabbed a little bit of this, but you know, just there's just not a whole lot out here, obviously, with everything so flat. So really didn't get a lot of trades in here, mostly in the morning when it first opened was really the best time in the market to grab something. ARK K is flat as well. Looking at the government bonds. So bonds was very flat. U.S. oil, flat. The dollar pulled down a little bit. But just sitting right below that 50 moving average. The VIX pulled down back down a little bit. Still, it's elevated at 24. If this can pull down here, more down towards 22, 25 or towards the 50 tomorrow, we get a nice little bump up. If there's a lot of fear in the market come in, this could spike tomorrow as well. But I do like the direction is actually to come down. So hopefully we can keep that momentum and get the market to rally here. SPY, obviously flat today. Triple Qs, flat. Semiconductors is flat. So, I mean, nothing really today. I mean, obviously the market did not want to take any direction or action today with all the news coming out. IWM, but it's flat as well. But, you know, the one thing that's nice about it, at least that means that there was a panic created in the marketplace. So that part's good because that's if we did, you know, then it could possibly push us lower. But, you know, not kind of a boring video probably for you today. Everything's pretty much flat, still looking, you know, again, for the same support and resistance areas that we talked about last night. XLV. Pretty well flat. XLK is flat as well. Bitcoin. So now Bitcoin, you know, we talked about this wedge and it broke out of the wedge that we talked about last night and came back and checked in, which I do like a lot. So a lot of times when you check in here and you get a bounce and then a rally off this. So I'm hoping what we see, because we got good support here, we get above this high here, around 45, I'll definitely be in. At least to see if we can continue to rally up here, you know, past 45, 850, and hopefully further. But do like this action so far. I mean, this is very common to see this bounce. So Bitcoin could be all ready to run, but also could be based on a lot of the news of what's going on as well. So GALA gives nice run, bumped over almost to resistance line here at 40, at 49.58, to almost hit the resistance line, but did get above the 200, but closed below the 200, which I don't like. So hopefully we can get above there tomorrow. But this is one we've been tracking. It's been moving forward. Just obviously trying to move over this last high of 50, and it tried to do that today, just fell short of it. So obviously it needs a little more energy and momentum and volume to come in and pick that up and move it. So we'll see what we can do there, see if that'll bump up there tomorrow, but that's still looking good. A CRO consolidating, it's kind of a downward trend. So, could be even this is pulling back a little bit. It's above the 20 and we're getting ready to have a bounce above. So a lot of this will, I think if Bitcoin takes off, you're going to see CRO take off as well. So that's our cryptos, our stocks, what we're watching, looking for continuation plays tomorrow. We'll see, definitely watch the VIX in the morning pre-market, as well as the other stocks to see, you know, which direction they're going to go. The first, you know, half hour of the day should tell us, you know, what direction the market may head. So just be careful out there. Again, you know, we're heading to the tail end of the week. We do have operations expiration on Friday, which means there could be a lot of volatility. So just be careful for swings in both directions. But definitely need some, need this night to let hopefully the market, take a look at all the news and decide what direction it wants to move. But be careful out there. We'll trade tomorrow. We'll talk tomorrow night, see how things are going and see how your day went and what we need to do to close out the week. Everybody have a great night.